Why won't 1 + 5 work? Got my red vines and my coffee. I'm gonna have problems later. Yeah.
Snap into a Slim Jim. Oh, yeah.
Why don't I use timelines? I just never have. I just never needed to, I guess. Never really saw a reason to. Like, if I need to really kind of lay down the script hammer for anything, like when things should happen or whatever, I usually track it, like, positionally or something. Give a fucks is a constant, always set to false. That's what we want. We want that. What the fuck? Did I just open up like... Ah, jeez. Graphic scale. Fuck you. yeah, okay. That's what it did. It didn't actually... That's weird. It does... I wonder how often I've been doing that and not even realizing. It's not opening the document. It's creating a new instance of graphic scale every time. Valley Strange. And not desired. Oh, sure. Yeah, I'm always curious about how anybody else's workflow works. Or what it consists of. Also, how do I like working with Tiled and GameMaker? I like it a lot. I like it a lot more than GameMaker's built-in room editor. No, a timeline in GameMaker. GameMaker has another asset type is called timelines. And I have used them so little that I almost don't even quite understand how they work. Like, the only time I had ever used a timeline was, like, in a tutorial or something. It's not like... a timeline in a non-linear editor sense or anything like that. It is something... It's a a series of events that you can create or define based on frame count and stuff like that. Like, a timeline is almost like its own version of a script or something. So you can have a bunch of different timelines, you know, like, say, for example, you're doing, like, a top-down 1942-style shooter. In level one, like, say, every 120 frames, create three instances of object enemy plane at the top of the screen, you know, stuff like that. If you use them in a way they're not intended, yeah, I bet you can. I have done like zero experimentation with them though. Yeah, so Stacy, it's not like the timeline like you would see in like a, you know, like an editor or something. Hey, Fluffy Simon, how's it going, man? They are like another asset, like a sprite or a background or a script or something like that. But my basic understanding is that they're like frame driven or step driven. Not bad. Not bad at all. Mr. Simon. Yeah, that was my understanding, is that they I mean, in the very literal sense of the word, they are a timeline. When a certain amount of time happens, this thing happens. I mean, especially if I have scripted events and stuff happening, you know, like a cinematic or something, I'm usually tracking like where things are. Like, if this guy makes it over to this point, you know, if his X is greater than whatever, everybody stop doing what you're doing and create a dialogue box and say something in it. Or switch to this animation or whatever. You have some god-awful chicory stuff there. I actually like, that kind of stuff. What the hell? No, we're not playing any licensed music. No, 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 no. Oh, it's because fucking... That's so weird, man. Like, if you are playing a playlist, this happened to me a couple streams ago too, where I used Music B for my music player, and it started playing stuff that was not outside of, you know, from my core library, music library, and not within the playlist that I told it to play. Oh yeah, see, I hate the flavored coffee stuff. I don't like the hazelnut or the vanilla or any of that. I like, especially since I used to flavor coffee. Like, I used to roast it and I used to flavor it. The oil that you would use to flavor was fucking crazy. Like, if any of it like would get on a label or something, like on the jug of oil that you had, if any of it dripped down onto the label, it would like immediately erase the printing on the label and shit like that. Chicory? No, chicory's That smoky shit. I don't know exactly. It's like a ground, like root or something, and you use it to, add a kind of a smoky flavor to stuff. Let's Google it though, just to. Here we go, chicory on the Wikipedia. Common chicory is a somewhat woody, perennial, herbaceous plant of the dandelion family, usually with bright blue flowers, rarely white or pink. Many varieties are cultivated for salad leaves and etc. The syrups are different. But yeah, monolithic, I'm same. I typically just like my shit like, don't put anything in it. Put any shit in there, you're gonna lose your hand at the wrist. Let's see. Let me turn on the music again. What was I saying? I lost my train of thought, but that's okay. I wasn't saying anything important anyway. Put that on. Yeah, flavored lattes are different in that you put that syrup in the drink, directly into the drink, instead of flavoring the beans after they're roasted, like letting them sit in oil. And that's where you get like the hazelnut flavored coffee and stuff like that. Yeah, I like the darker beers too. Black, looking like pure despair. Greetings, Cohen. Thanks for that host, man. Yeah, I prefer like Russian imperial stouts and stuff. Rarely drink anymore, though. More is the pity. Yes, super good. Years ago, my drummer worked at the drummer in one of the bands I was in. He worked at Stone Brewery in Southern California. So he always used to bring tons of fucking alcohol. Yeah, see, I don't really like IPAs very much anymore. IPA can go to hell. We can go to hell and die. You know what I actually really like, though, too, is Fat Tire. whatever their just like normal standard Belgian fat tire is. And that shit seems almost like it was made to go with pizza. Okay, well that's compiling. Do some more work on this guy. Terrible 15 years ago? It wasn't until maybe 6-7 years ago that I had Fat Tire for the first time. It was super good. Remember when you thought Guinness was amazing? I never liked Guinness. Coming from a guy who was raised Irish Catholic, of all things. It just never... I was like, ugh. This tastes like fucking Chef Boyardee of Italian. Or something. I can't do the Bailey's either. Any sweet stuff kind of makes my stomach turn a little bit when you put it in alcohol. I don't know why, but I get kind of sick. A lot of car bombs. See, yeah, that stuff starts to make me feel like too full. Not drunk, but too full. Like I gotta go burst or something. 2 for $6. Jesus. Wind up in the emergency room like every night. Over here. Not like they'll help. What the fuck? They won't stop drinking this shit. We can't keep up. Hands and feet have always been like, I either nail it or they look like hideous mutated appendages. Unless I'm going for hideous nightmarish mutated appendages, in which case, nailed it! Here, though, not necessarily the look I'm going for. Hey, salad donks. Just draw circles for hands and wedges for me, right? That's how the professionals do it. Yeah, that's all. He's just an alien. Doesn't like you. I don't like you either. The breastplate. I'll bring out that finger just a little more. No, yeah, now it's starting to look clubbed or something. Oh shit, in a little while, not right now, but in a little bit, I have to go order some food. It's me and the missus. We're going to have some Chinese food. Buy you a pizza? In the mood for pizza? I'm pretty much always in the mood for pizza. That's how I maintain my glorious figure. This is a good plan. keeps you nice and productive, potentially. She needs some Mai Tais. Those would go kind of good. Depending on what you got with them. That does sound kind of good. This talk of booze, too, has made me want to drink today. We don't have anything, though. We are bone dry here right now. That's okay. I'm just trying to get the shapes down first. Fill it in a sec. You had mellow mushroom for the first time in ages. We used to get mellow mushroom all the time when we first moved to Austin.
but I think there were a few times where we got it where it really wasn't that good. So we stopped. So I haven't had it in a while. There is a service in Texas that has, what's it called? I forget now, but it's like kind of like Favor, you know, like how Favor works, which is sort of an all-purpose delivery system. It's like, I need some crayons, Sat. They'll bring you some. there's one that's specifically for alcohol. And I forget what they're called, though, now. I am not drunk enough. Please help. Also, I need crayons. She needs to jump more when she's on the bear, I think. Yeah, there's a streamer-centric food delivery app or whatever. Platform, whatever you'd call it. Specifically for sending streamers snacks and shit. Stream gift, or I can't remember what it's called. What that's called either. I can't remember what anything's called. What's my name? Sure, most places it was that was a fun thing when I lived in LA. I think before really any of these sort of convenience driven sort of mobile services existed yet, like Favor or Uber or Lyft or any of that shit, one that had been in LA for years was Pink Dot, and Pink Dot would just bring you whatever the fuck you wanted. You know, booze, medicinal pot, you know, you're like, I need some batteries, some ramen, 12 copies of Penthouse, a 40 of Mickey's, and a coloring book. They would deliver it to you. Drone-based booze delivery for streamers. Before you know it, we'd have some kind of like nationwide God's must be crazy situation going on. A banana and some whipped cream. Right? Not scuzzy in the slightest. Ah, son of a bitch. Alright. Time to talk to the hand once again. You mentioned, how did I tackle faking mode 7? I just used Game Maker's 3D draw stuff. Like for, let's see here. Let's use a little visual aid here. So you can actually see what I'm saying. It's really easy if you use Game Maker's stuff. So I'm using real 3D to draw fake 3D, essentially. Where can we go that we'll be able to, I think this works. Make sure that we start in here. Surgeon General calls for more liver donors. The easy squeeze lube and a dozen gerbils. It's for science. Make sure that the gerbils do not have any loved ones, family, or friends. Yeah, if you're gonna do like full on 3D, like there are about a billion better, more complete options out there, I think. Though, I mean, people have been able to do some crazy shit with Game Maker 3D wise, but they really went the extra mile. But like, yeah, I'm doing is, positioning the viewpoint, you know, and using Game Maker's 3D draw floor texture calls to draw the actual map, and then using draw wall, D3D draw wall or whatever, to draw all the props that are, you know, kind of popping up out of the ground. Same thing with the sprites and everything on the world map. Neon Gaming, best way to make a game like this. Are you talking about the Mode 7 stuff? So yeah, there's really no trickery behind it. It's just I'm using Game Maker's built-in 3D crap to do it. Nothing fancy. Saladongs, yeah, I think that's the main thing that people have gotten excited about is the world map. Which is funny because mechanically it really doesn't do much. All you're doing is you're moving a box around a big space with other boxes. Which arguably that's what you're doing in the platformer stuff too. I mean, but you're not really interacting with anything on the world map. You're not, you know... Mechanically, there's really nothing interesting about this. It just looks cool. And it sort of suggests a kind of imaginary depth to the game, you know? Like, even the boat, you know, all the boat is doing is just swapping out collision masks for, like, now instead of the water being solid, now the land is solid and just changes your sprite, you know? But people got really excited about that, too. It's like, oh my god, you're on a ship! Whereas mechanically, it's really nothing, you know, nothing really going on. Maybe I shouldn't be saying this stuff, but whatever. what was I getting at? Oh, and another funny thing too is, just for shits and giggles, not this current one, but the previous years, Game Developers Conference and Indie Game, whatever it's called, awards thing. The judges will give you feedback. You have no idea who they are, though, and, you know, where they've come from or anything. But eventually, at some point, they will send you little notes on your game. And one of the most common ones I got was, get rid of the overworld map. It's stupid and ugly, and games are way more interesting when they're more like Metroid. Shit like that. I was like, actually, people really want the sort of mode 70 world map thing. Like, I'm not ditching that. Sorry. Also, sorry you didn't like the game. But I mean, obviously, they don't leave you any means of talking to the judges either. Like, you can't, like, you know, ask them to elaborate or anything. They just kind of give their opinion, and that's that. Excuse me. Not that I would have anyway. I wasn't really too interested to hear anything further on that point necessarily. Your opinion based punching bears in the butt. Yep. That is definitely a feature of Savage. Never remove the mud. I don't want to. I like it too much. Though obviously I'm, you know. I mean, it could. It very well may be crappy, but like I said, I think it sort of gives the illusion of some added value and content and depth to the game. You know, like, just like any good prop is supposed to. It's supposed to enhance the experience. Like, same thing as with games, you know, like the old Final Fantasy and Dragon Warrior games. Like, the world maps, like, it's supposed to simply convey a sense of adventure and exploration. Like, on those maps, you're not really doing anything. You're just moving a bounding box around and trying to find other bounding boxes to collide with, or, you know, randomly running into a fight scenario or something. Like, it's not... If you look at it mechanically, it's not very interesting, but... there are certain things that you can do for your project, whether it's a game or a movie or anything, that can sweeten the pot a little. You know, it's confectionery. It's purely there for flavor or fluff or whatever you want to call it. You know, maybe it doesn't move the plot forward, or it doesn't add anything mechanically interesting, or, you know, its offerings are purely there for fun. Now, of course, there are things that you can do that are confectionery in nature that can hurt, you know, if too much sort of focus is put on something like that, or maybe it doesn't feel that great, or, you know, there's like a billion things that could potentially go wrong at any given moment, so just kind of trust yourself and be like, we're waiting for this game, and if I were wanting to play this game, do things like the map sort of sweeten the experience a little bit for me, or potentially hurt it, or, you know, am I excited about this? Am I not excited about it? Is probably the best sort of compass, the best guiding light that you have when it comes to shit like that. Maybe. Now I'm rambling. Sorry. I went into grandstanding mode there for a second. Sorry about that. But they're definitely interesting concepts to kind of, you know, explore mentally and talk about, I think. You know, like maybe the person or people that gave me that feedback were very mechanically driven, you know, maybe they or maybe they're very used to a certain way of thinking or whatever, and that's why they didn't like the world map. But because I mean, visually the world map's not that great either. Like, there's a lot of junky old resources on there that only appear on the world map and maybe clash with the visuals of the actual platformy bits. You're apt to think that the sort of person who seeks to be chosen as a judge might be prone to ego issues. That could be too. You think the map adds a certain fullness to the game that might not be as strong without it? Yeah, I think so too. Like, it's kind of connective tissue, right? It's flavor. It's the gap bridger. It fills things in and gives it kind of a, you know, like a low end sort of, or brings everything kind of together and visually informs you a little bit about where you are. And you know, you have fun just looking. Yeah, and I don't mean to spoil the fun by talking about it mechanically like this, but it's just, it's interesting that it's a thing that doesn't really serve any real mechanical purpose. I mean, you could get rid of the map and still visit every area in the game if you just linked the rooms. You know, you just never go to the map. But it just adds an extra something to the game world and gives the world a character that it might not otherwise have necessarily. You're gonna make a game where you don't move your character at all. You wait for encounters to happen. Cactus Quest. Your goal is to get your quills stuck in people's butt cheeks. Is that a real thing? I wonder if you can make a hands-off game fun. That would definitely be an interesting experiment. People play Cookie Clicker. Anything is possible. See, that's the thing. Games is such a fucking broad thing already. I would argue even more so than, you know, other media like books and movies. Because you can approach and build and experience a game in so many different ways that the spectrum is a lot wider and deeper. As far as you know, Cactus Quest doesn't exist, and the world is a poorer place for it. I think it should. Just your little quick little treatment there. Just that sentence. At least I got a kick out of it. I can see that on the back of a box. In other words. And buy it because of it. That's kind of... Super cheap just like with the Capra Demon fight. And maybe just copy-paste that hand over to here. Because he's just holding reins on his raptor mount. That's all he's doing. I'll fix that up a little bit. He also has gauntlets on that I haven't applied to him just yet. But you pop cats that have been blown up like balloons. There you go. Instant seller. It'd be, yeah, just a cactus and nothing happens. And maybe some tumbleweeds roll by that you can't interact with because you're stuck. Cowboys. cactuses. The original cowboy trap. Okay. Now we can kind of trim his flesh down a little bit. And the arms. What it is, we have no idea. What it is. No one was told. If she looked inside, well, maybe she'd find the reason why everything's wrong. She hides. Bring that out a little bit. She hides. See, there's some of this. It's gonna get hit in the head because he's got bracers. Also, I like that word cactus brethren. That's something you don't hear too often. Too much banding going on. Or whatever the pixel art professionals call it. And the game ends with Hunter S. Thompson cutting you down and eating you to get high. That's bad country! Not sure what I'm gonna do with this little piece here, but may as well just kind of start to fill it in some. he's gonna have another armor piece on here and a belt and everything. Yeah, I've had a big freaking unreasonable hankering to play the Kingsfield games again, and the Shadow Tower stuff lately. These games are so weird. Weird but super neat. Yeah, they're very strange. The controls are way dated, though. Controls are bizarre as hell. Like, I know in Shadow Tower you can kind of customize them, or you can remap them, but, like, by default, the triggers, or, like, the L2 and R2 buttons on the PlayStation, original PlayStation gamepad, are your, like, look up and down, L1 and R1 are your strafe, and turning and moving forward and backward are on the D-pad, and then, like, all your other shit are on the face buttons. Pretty sure in the Kingsfield stuff, like, you cannot remap. But I haven't played those in years. I recently played Shadow Tower a little bit, but, so that's why the control remapping is fresh in my brain. I'm almost starting to make this look like a scarab or something. Not intended. But yeah, they're really cool. They kind of feel like you're trying to sleep and you had a nightmare. And you just took a bunch of, like, NyQuil or something. They feel very fever dreamy. And holy shit, some of the enemy design... Like, I know it's on PlayStation 1, but some of the enemy design... and the models and the animation are super fucking crazy and cool in Shadow Tower. I know there's a sequel to Shadow Tower on PlayStation 2, and there's also an... like a fourth Kingsfield game on PlayStation 2, but I haven't played those. Also, the first Kingsfield game that they made only came out in Japan, but you can get, like, a translated version of it. There's a freaking online community that still makes Kingsfield-like games because there's an editor that you can use to build your own, like, Kingsfield-style video game called Moonsword or something like that, which is super fascinating. It reminds me of, like, how the Dreamcast scene is still going, you know? Like, people are still making homebrew Dreamcast games and stuff. It's like, Volgar the Viking got ported to Dreamcast. Like, are you kidding? That is equal parts ridiculous and amazing. And I mean, I know people are still building games for stuff like Genesis, Nintendo, and Super Nintendo. I just like that. I like that 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 is still happening, that that is a thing that is going on. Get more creative with this. Call stomach plate. He's got one of them, sort of like circular-ish pieces of armor covering his gut. I'll probably make it a lot bigger than that. I will sort of refine the shape of it and give it an outline as well. Try to sort of define the shape a little more with some highlighting. And other stuff of the like. Allergy medicine that I've been taking is making me feel kind of calm. It's like I'm not doing art. I feel like I'm coloring. if the distinction makes sense. I'm just like coloring. Yeah, just coloring.
weird 80s muscles. It's the only way I know how to draw muscles. Watch too much Fist of the North Star. Looked at the clock. It's time for the wife and I to go get some food and such. This is an hour shorter than usual, but I'll do more of these this week. As well as some podcasting material and stuff, and a general game update too. That's due for this week as well. But anyway, thank you guys so much for hanging out. Make sure you add the game Savage the Shard of Ghosts under your wishlist on Steam. You can keep track of it there with all the major project advancements and game updates that I post on there. And everybody have a great one. Thanks so much for hanging out, and I will see you next time.